In the last video I reassembled the CNC machine with the freshly cut acetal plates, and in this video I'm going to level the wasteboard, square the axes and tram the spindle. But first I'm having a go at cutting some aluminium.
I didn't put any tabs on this, so it's obviously cut into the side there, but
considering I didn't use any cutting fluid, the 1/8 of an inch bit went through the material quite well. I was cutting at 15,000 RPM with a feed rate of 200 millimeters a minute, a plunge rate of 80 millimeters a minute, and a step down of 0.2 millimeters. The 15 millimeter square came out 15.06 millimeters along the x-axis and 14.82 millimeters along the y. The y-axis on this machine is between the front and back, and it's likely the spindle is nodding, which is contributing to the error.
See, the opposite side is when last time I cut this material was with the X-carve.
The nut block, locking collars and couplers are all secured, and there is no obvious movement in that direction. I have already surfaced the wasteboard, and after measuring between opposite corners, the X and Y assembly seem square. However, there is a noticeable pattern in the MDF because the spindle is dipping along the y-axis. This is called a nod.
I can see from the surfacing I've done of the wasteboard, there is a slight raise on the back of the machine, so this is actually tilting forward. I can tell that just from looking at the pattern left behind. From side to side though, it looks pretty good.
I'm going to check the alignment of the spindle by placing a dial gauge on an arm into the collar of the spindle and checking how consistent opposite points are. If the spindle is tilting, the dial gauge will not read the same at opposite points, and I'll be able to identify this. But first I need to make an adapter collar to fit the arm onto the shaft of a 1/4 inch cutting bit. I picked a CNC bit which happened to have a short cutting head and a long surface to clamp against.
So with this open, I'll just check the inside diameter. It's about 12, and this is obviously 1/4 inch.
I cut this out from a scrap piece of acetal and then cut through the wall so the collar could be compressed.
This time I'm going to cut with a step down of 2 mil at a time. That's the side with the dust shoe kept on. Barely anything escaped. On that side, well, you can see how messy this machine can be. Okay, that feels nice and tight. Okay, that's how I turn off the signal to the spindle. So if I accidentally press something and it were to turn on, or the signal were to be sent, it won't actually receive it. Okay, I'm going to have to take the dust shoe off.
Because this is a desktop CNC machine, the profile is quite small and I couldn't get the dial gauge directly behind the spindle along the y-axis. I should have also put some glass on the wasteboard to help with tramming and avoid some of the holes I'd already made on the MDF.
That's pretty good.
But I managed to get some readings.
So I only moved 2 lines. So across here, it's only 0.02 mil off.
However, from the front to the back, it feels like 1 millimeter, or maybe a little less.
So the spindle is leaning forward like this, and according to this it's close to a millimetre.
The error with the nod is mainly caused by the weight of the spindle pulling the V-wheels on the gantry. Now this is where I have to admit that I didn't tram the plywood machine, in fact I completely overlooked it. And I did notice after I cut the new plates, all the openings were ever so slightly narrower at the bottom of the cut than they were at the top. This would have also been along the Y-axis predominantly, and may have also contributed to the nod. But for the most part, it's the weight. If I place an engineer square on the gantry across the two plates, you can see the gap on the plate closest to the front of the machine is about 0.5 mil.
Okay, so these are some of the offcuts from the actual cutouts of the plates. This bit here, it's about 0.6. If I cut that out and push that into the back for now, I'll tighten it up and have a look.
I placed some shims directly behind the spindle, but it later occurred to me that despite this squaring the bit to the wasteboard, the error lies further back, and the bit would travel along the Y-axis as the Z-axis moved up and down. I decided to check the rest of the machine a little more thoroughly. While examining the Y plate, I noticed the aluminium C-beam on the right hand side had an imperfection.
When I slide this across, it hits onto the edge here. So it's almost like this section here is a bit lower. I put that there.
A section seemed a bit lower than it should, and I'm not sure if this is affecting how the wheels rest.
You see this side's a lot flatter.
I didn't surface the acetyl to make the two outside faces parallel, so I'm in no doubt that they are anywhere near perfect.
That means there's something wrong with the profile. Okay, so the Y plates are a little bit out. It could be that when I was fitting all the corner plates that I just tightened them up too close together and they're pulling the plate in a bit. Maybe if I loosen these up, I'll be able to actually slide it around a bit.
The X-axis C-beam is also not entirely 90 degrees to the wasteboard, but the holes for the X-axis are 90 degrees to the fixed wheels further down the plate, which run along the Y-axis.
Okay, I'm loosening all of these machine screws along this aluminium extrusion and the one at the front to see whether I can adjust this somewhat. I'll also loosen all of these under here. I don't have any clamps that I can reverse and push these out, so I use the hammer.
I moved the gantry to one side and tightened the machine screws, and then back to the opposite side where I secured the remaining ones.
Okay, 496 all along.
I can't tell if that's made much of a difference. I am going to square the Z-axis now, and to do this I had to take the entire gantry off. I had some thin 0.35mm washers which I placed between the gantry on the back of the Z-axis C-beam. I placed two washers on either machine screw at the bottom and one washer on the two middle machine screws. To square the Z-axis along the X-axis, I simply pushed the C-beam to one side. That's how I did it previously and the results were pretty good.
Okay, I think I've got this as square as I possibly can. If I put a light.
I checked for squareness by placing an engineer square against the bit in the collet and the wasteboard. I then placed the dial gauge back into the collet and compared the reading from opposite sides. The X-axis looks less than 0.1mm, so maybe not as good as the first time, but still pretty good. And along the diagonal it was similar, so about 0.08mm. I then surfaced the wasteboard, this time with a large step over of 90%, and used a straight edge and torch to visually compare the cuts along the X and Y axis.
There is a pattern. It's a little bit higher on the right hand side, which means the spindle is tilting to the left at the top. In terms of the front and back, it's still nodding down a tiny bit, but it's a lot less than the x-axis. There's a little bit of light bleeding, but you're talking very, very, very small, maybe 0.01 or 2 of a mil, maybe even less than that, barely any light coming through. About 0.02, I can live with that. I'm just going to run the area clear again with the step over a little bit smaller, just so I can get rid of these corner bits that were missed, and then that should be it. The machine's ready to go.
This is still an improvement, but I don't particularly want to spend more time calibrating. Without designing something to adjust the axes incrementally, I don't think I'll get it much better. I decided to try and machine some aluminium again. The settings were the same as the first time, but this time I cut a 20 by 20 millimeter square.
So I put some tabs just to stop it coming out. It looks like it's cut really well.
The results were really impressive. 20.04 millimeters along the y-axis and 19.99 along the x-axis. So this problem with the nod has prompted me to change the plate design, and I'll show you what I've done. The holes on the Y plates, which accept the mounting machine screws that go into the X-axis C-beam, I've actually stretched them. I've made them about 4 degrees wider on either side. What this means is I can loosen those and pivot the z-axis. So if I just go to edit profile sketch, you can see this a little bit better. The shape is based on a center point, which is the center of the threaded rod. So this means I don't have to change or adjust anything to do with the coupler, the threaded rod, the nut block, or the stepper motors. And once I've found that position, I can lock the four down plus the two angle brackets underneath either end of the x-axis, and it actually works very effectively. If you imagine the clamping pressure of a machine screw is probably quite a lot, maybe 30 to 40 kilos, when all of these on either side are tightened, I think it's more likely that the bit will break if the machine ran into problems than for the pivot to come out of alignment. So this is my design innovation to deal with that problem of the nod. I've not seen this on any of the other CNC machines, and I think this is going to make a massive difference to the calibration time, and also make the calibration so much easier. You can imagine, if I stop the sketch, you can imagine possibly having a machine screw maybe on the inside here, which can be set, so once these are loosened, you can incrementally adjust the angle and then lock it back down again. I cut out a test section of the Y plate out of some scrap MDF, and you can see how the X-axis C-beam can pivot here, and in this shot how the center of the acme threaded rod opening remains centered. So I think it's time to make this version of the plates available on open builds. I did start from an open source design, so it's only fair to end there. But I'm going to also start working on a manual to accompany these videos and this project, and I'll be dedicating a page to thank all the patrons who have supported this channel and this build. As per usual, please sacrifice a thumb and let the algorithm gods know what you think. If you're new to this channel and want to support it, you can become a paid subscriber on Patreon, where any changes to this CNC machine or future designs will be made available there before general release. I'm going to also try make more Patreon-only feed videos, so that's something else to look forward to. Anyway, thanks again, and you'll see me in the next one.